opposing social visions, intellectuals in society, quote, at the heart of the social vision prevalent among contemporary intellectuals is the belief that there are problems and solutions, close yeah. quote. Explain that.
Well, the people with the vision of the anointed, as I call it, believe there are solutions and that intellectuals have the inside track in providing those solutions. Those with the opposite vision understand there are no solutions. There are trade-offs. And, you can make this a little bit better by making something a little bit worse. Or you can make it a little bit better by making something a lot worse. And right now, for example, this mania for high-speed rail, there's no question that if you're willing to pour enough money down the rat hole, we can have high-speed rail.
We can have it.
They have it in Spain. One of the economics professors in Spain said, you know, not only are they not covering the operating costs, there's not been $1 collected towards the infrastructure. I mean, like the rails and the trains, they haven't gotten $1 to pay for that. They're not even covering the cost of running the trains on a daily basis, you know, the conductors and the electricity.
So you've got, in intellectuals in society, you draw this contrast between what you call the vision of the anointed. Mm. We, the anointed, because of our intellect, our superior, I'm denigrating the view because I share your view that it's all nonsense,
yes.
but it's not nonsense to them. So what's the fair way to put it? What is it?
They have more knowledge than other people.
We know more than most people.
That's right.
Therefore, we are in a position to survey society, see specific problems, and propose solutions. That's one fundamental vision which runs through much of Western civilization, as you demonstrate here. And the opposing vision is commonsensical, tragic. You can't solve certain problems. We will all die. There is human beings are in some ways perverse. This would be the vision, you argue, of the founding fathers. You check ambition with ambition. Checks and balances. Power is dangerous. So why is it, if you've got these two fundamental visions, the vision of the anointed and the tragic vision of life, and they run through much of Western civilization, why is it the vision of the anointed that is the persistent temptation of intellectuals? Why are they drawn to that?
It gives them a much bigger role in the world. I mean, if you believe in free markets, what about all these people who want to have social justice? People just go out there, they make whatever deals they can with each other, work things out, and go on their way. And here is all this unused brilliance standing on the sideline, watching with impotent rage.
The tragic vision confines intellectuals to the classroom. The vision of the anointed lets them run society. That's the difference?
Roughly.
So what you're saying is that it's just human pride. It's a kind of vulgar urge to power.
Oh, absolutely.
And nothing more than that.
Well, that's sufficient for many people.
All right.